Are you like okay?
Yes, this is a happy sigh. Can't you tell my sighs apart?
No, you've literally never done that before.
I'm happy because I can freely talk about Christmas without you jumping down my throat.
I'm scared.
I freely released my Christmas spirit and I am ready. I've been listening to All I Want for Christmas all day.
Wait, no.
Now it's on replay in my head.
That's copyrighted. We can't sing that. Okay, maybe this is starting to go a little bit too far. All right? I don't want to get copyrighted.
Don't take this away from me.
Look, that song's a bop. I know it's a bop, but I mean, does anybody else feel like we've completely switched personalities? Like, I'm usually the, quirky one on the show around here. Quirky. But we really need to get on with the show. I mean, the audience is patiently waiting. So, I'm Jackson, even though she's acting kind of like a small, short, feminine version
really?
Of me at the moment.
Lorelai, and I'm acting just like myself.
No, you're not.
Thank you very much.
You're not at all.
I'm just so excited for Christmas.
And I'm scared.
I am not acting like you.
Are you insinuating that is a bad thing? As if people do not strive to be like me?
What?
At least that's confident as me.
No. Today on The Buzz, we have an interview with the Orange Vest Queen, Catherine Wooten, another Toby's friend with Megan, and a really fun culinary as well.
I feel like you just avoided something with me.
I'm not avoiding anything.
Speaking oh, yeah.
Of
oh, sure.
Things,
sure.
Megan never told us what she was doing for culinary.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Keeping us in the dark.
Completely. Like, why is that? I, for one, am not a fan of surprises unless, you know, I'm in on them because I like scaring people because I'm that kind of good. But I want to know.
I guess we'll find out then.
But I want to know right now. Okay, what's the first thing that comes to mind when you think of Plaquemines Parish?
Actually, there are a lot of things.
I said the first thing, Laura, like.
Well. Oranges.
Yeah, good answer. It's almost as if it was scripted. Yes, Plaquemines Parish is very well known for its citrus industry, which is very fine, might I add. So much so, we have miles and miles of citrus groves, like everywhere. You can't miss them if you drive down the road. They're just everywhere.
We have so many oranges. We have neighbors that are constantly giving us bags of satsumas. I'm sure we all know at least one person with a tree in their backyard.
At least. We also have an annual festival called the Orange Festival.
The Orange Festival was formed back in 1947 in order to promote cultivation and marketing of Plaquemines citrus. What? A deep freeze back in 1941 nearly destroyed the organization before it began, and it was enlarged to include all bounty of the parish. The Orange Festival became known as the Plaquemines Parish Fair and Orange Festival.
Thank you for that brief look back at history. Throughout history, harsh winters and very devastating hurricanes such as Betsy, Camille, and Katrina have devastated the citrus industry and therefore impacted the fair and Orange Festival. But the courageous citrus growers of Plaquemines Parish have continued to push on and regrow their crop, and the industry lives on to this day. The festival continues to be a main attraction in Plaquemines Parish and will go forward this year despite the, you know, COVID-19 situation, global pandemic.
Stay tuned as we interview Catherine Wooten, the 2019 Plaquemines Parish Fair and Orange Festival Queen.
Sounds exciting.
We are here in the Imaginarium Studios today with Catherine Wooten, the 2019 Plaquemines Parish Fair and Orange Festival Queen. So the first thing I want to do is I want to thank you so much for coming in to talk to us today.
Thank you for having me.
So with the Orange Festival would be coming up very soon. It would be the first weekend of December. Since you can't have the festival this year, what are you guys planning on doing instead?
Well, since all Orange Festival events are officially canceled, we decided that we want to have visiting queens as we would, you know, if the festival is actually happening. And we're just going to take them through Plaquemines Parish and let them see, you know, what would happen if we were putting the festival on and, you know, some of the events like the kumquat stuffing games, stuff like that, just to give them a little taste of the parish.
That makes sense. And I know that in the parish, the orange industry is very important. Can you try to tell us like why it's very important in our parish?
Right. So, you know, across the state, whenever I come in contact with people and we bring them satsumas or we bring them navels or whatever's in season, every time they try a slice, they're like, okay, this is so much better than anything I found in Walmart or I found in Target. And the citrus industry in Plaquemines Parish is just, it's very rich and it's very, unique. There's something special about our produce here, and everyone that tries it loves it. And so it's a way that a lot of families, you know, make their living, and just, I don't know, it's just a sense of community at home where you take a bite of that orange and it's so sweet and it's amazing.
Okay, so our next question is, what role does the queen play in the fair and the festival?
As the queen, I have the job of promoting the industry and just, you know, sharing a little bit of Plaquemines Parish with everyone that I come in contact with on the weekends during the year.
What other responsibilities come along with that?
As queen, it's just a matter of, you know, being a strong presence on social media, sharing everything and all the things orange, you know, just really keeping the festival in everyone's minds.
Okay, so as we know, as we discussed already, the COVID has affected the Orange Festival this year, unfortunately. So you were the 2019 queen. Are you continuing to serve as the queen this year?
Yes, so they extended my reign and I will be giving up next September.
Has there ever been a two-term queen?
No, I'm the first ever.
It is cool to be the first ever two-time queen.
It is.
So doing our research, we learned that you were majoring in criminal justice in college. What made you decide to pick that major?
Growing up, I just always had an interest in politics and law, and so I thought criminal justice was a good way to kind of incorporate both and just see what direction I wanted to go in with my future.
Our final question for you is our question that we ask every guest. It's my favorite question. I know it's my co-host, it's Jackson's favorite question too. If you could go back in time, give yourself advice at the age of 16, even if you weren't 16 that long ago, what would you tell yourself?
I would just tell myself to be 100% sure of who I am and not to worry about, you know, other people's opinions or pleasing other people. Just do what I want to do for myself and make myself happy.
That's great. That's something that I think we all need to hear and that we all need to take into our lives. And I'm sure I will. I'm sure they will, too. Well, thank you so much for coming on to the show. The Orange Festival is definitely something to look forward to. So even though it's not happening this year, we will look forward to when it returns.
Right. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
These are going to be the bomb.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Just the best thing that's ever going to happen to hot chocolate. Ever.
That still doesn't answer the question.
Obviously.
You wouldn't tell us what you had planned for the culinary. You've kept us in suspense long enough. What is this?
Yeah.
Fine, today we're going to be making hot chocolate bombs.
Bombs? Wait, so they are like going to be the bomb.
Yes, Jackson. I was making a pun. Finally, you get it.
Awesome.
But hot cocoa bombs sound really awesome. Care to elaborate?
Yes.
I would love to, but I'll need help, which one of you will help me in this week's culinary segment?
Obviously me.
Look, I only need one partner, and I'm not choosing. You two have to figure this on your own.
Why can't we both be?
It looks like I need to get something, one more ingredient.
Well, no, we're not done.
I'm gonna be right back, and you better do this, and you guys have to decide and not make a mess. I set up everything perfectly.
I won't make a mess.
Okay, so how do we decide this?
I'm thinking we negotiate. So how about you do next week's interview, and I get to do culinary?
Wait. You really want to trade me this culinary for an interview? Look, interviews are fun and all, but culinary is way more fun. How about this instead? I'll do this culinary and you can do next week's.
Come on. This one is made for me. They are bombs made of chocolate. You know how many puns are in store?
And you think I wouldn't enjoy a bomb made of chocolate? Did you ever think about that, Jackson?
So I believe we are at what they call a impasse. So what do we do?
Rock, paper, scissors? Best two out of three?
Oh yeah, sure, I'm gonna do that.
Okay,
right,
okay.
Yeah.
Yes, we did.
It'll be great. Let's get started. We're going to show everyone how to add some holiday magic to their Christmas season. We have all the ingredients and things that you'll need laid out. You'll need chocolate bark, a silicone mold tray, a bowl for melting your chocolate, a hot plate, mini marshmallows, hot chocolate mix, and sprinkles if you want it.
We've got sprinkles.
Lorelai is going to demonstrate as I explain how to make it.
Yes. Okay, so when do we get to the bomb part?
That's at the end.
That's a bit anticlimactic.
First, we're going to melt... First, we're going to melt the bowl of bark for chocolate bark for 1 to 2 minutes.
We have that right here.
Once that is melted,
ready?
Stir until smooth. Then take this as... Take the back of a spoon and with a little bit, you're going to coat the mold tray with a layer of chocolate. Make sure that the entire mold is all the way around the thing, so even at the bottom.
Should I use another spoon to scrape it off? That might be a good idea. Okay.
Have that.
Ah, look at that.
Amazing.
Okay, there we go. Okay, make sure whenever you do this, consider using an oven mitt or a pot holder because that's a little bit safer. We don't have one on us right now.
Yep, so we have to be careful not to be burned. And gently take one of the halves and touch the edge to the hot part of the plate.
Like this?
Yeah.
This? This. Okay, I got it.
Yeah.
Sorry,
this
is making me really hungry. Just gotta kinda make sure it gets a little... Move it around a little bit.
Until the chocolate melts. Do this for both halves.
A nice melty edge. Grab the other one. I'll put this here, and then we can go ahead and get the other one, and then you put it together, right?
No!
What?
You haven't put in the yummy stuff yet.
All this stuff, and then the yummy stuff, you have to be more specific!
Before the edge cools, you have to put the hot chocolate mix, marshmallows, and sprinkles in the bottom.
Oh, that makes sense. Then we close them?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna grab this. I'll put in a good scoop of hot cocoa mix. That's kind of, And then grab some marshmallows. Get those in there.
Maybe take like 3, 4, 5.
I've got 5 in there right now. And sprinkles.
What color should we do?
I don't know. Let's see, we got all kinds of pretty colors. Let's do these because these are really small and they're kind of cute. So I'm gonna make a mess, but you know, that's okay. That's the fun.
That's what kitchen
and then
is all about.
Stick them together like this. There you go.
Then you can decorate however you want them to do it with more sprinkles and then freeze them so they'll be ready.
Hey guys, it's Jackson with The Buzz. Now, 2020 has been a crazy year for Liaya, and due to COVID, we haven't been able to do any of the fundraisers that we usually do, especially the ones that our community has come to love. But to raise some funds so we can keep on producing shows like The Buzz, on December 18th, Liaya is holding a silent auction where you can win some amazing, amazing things, such as artwork made by Liaya members and prizes donated by Liaya supporters. So please tune in on December 18th and help us raise some money at the silent auction. I'll be seeing you guys on the next episode of The Buzz. Bye-bye.
Oh man, those hot chocolate bombs were so good.
You cheated.
I feel like the one I made was like, It was awesome.
No, it wasn't.
Jackson, you want to come over here, Jackson?
No.
But Jackson. Jackson, we need to close the show. If you could just come.
All right, but I'm not doing it because you asked me to.
Are you sure? Now that Jackson's here, anything you would like to say, Jackson?
While I may have been defeated today, I will arise like a phoenix.
Fair.
Coming
okay.
back. back to win again.
I won fair and square, though.
Fighting over to conquest the tyranny that is short Lorelei. Napoleon in this case.
Why? Okay. Before
because
he goes
you
on,
are.
Before he goes on for 20 minutes about how mad he is at me for beating him at rock and
in this
scissors.
Day shall stand as a loss.
I'm Lorelei. And you are?
The rightful Jackson, winner.
And we'll see you next week on the bus.
Or will we?
What?